Shalom uvracha. I will be speaking with today about whether energy has free choice or not. Now, it sounds a bit weird of a topic, energy, free choice. What does those two subjects have to do one to the other? But I felt this was important because I was inspired by a good friend of mine, Bo Fleischman, in order to make this video. Okay, because we're a little bit of discussion, and you'll see in the context of what I'm learning over here in Otot Chaim, the Leshem Shebu Achlama, and Shah Kavanas, how this makes sense. Okay, so let's just jump into this. So this is going to be a more advanced shiur for those who've learned Kabbalah already, understand the language. And for those who don't, well, maybe try to be in contact with me, maybe I'll try to explain something a bit more with words that people would understand better without the language of Kabbalah. But anyways, in this class, we'll be learning Otzot Chaim. And Otzot Chaim, Sha'a Kudim Perek Bet, and in the old editions, Daf Gimel Amud Aleph, it is as follows. Gam Yesh Siba Acheret. Now here he's discussing a very, right in the middle of a sugi over here, but let's go through the teretz and I'll explain to you what he's trying to refer to. He krovela niska vuhu kihine o makif choshku v'chofzu lidabik imo or apenimi. Here he's discussing, and how is it keli, how does it get cleansed? So he says that Keli has, these are those words of the Arizal, again, also Shah Akudim Perek Dalet on Daf Gimel in Matuk Midvash is page Mem Zayin. He says, the O Makiv Choshku V'choftsu Lidabikim Openim. The light has an incredible Cheshik and Chafetz. It really wants to do it, it has a will. Well, Ratzon is usually, Chefetz is more of a stronger language, more of a humanistic language. Ratzon is more of a colloquial word in general. Lidabiki mo'o penimi. Since the Omaki wants to enter into the Keli, that's how it synthesizes and cleanses the Keli, because it has such an entire, an amazing inner will. I would call the inner choshku v'choftzu lidabik bo penimi. Chen hu chatzia dofen shalakiri mitzad achitzon lo yozach yote lo yover o bo o makif. Okay, so you see from here, just the lotion of that is when he talks about lights and when we're talking about energy, he's giving it humanistic qualities called choshku v'choftzu lidabik. That's one marmikom. Let's continue onwards. The otzo tzrayin shakudim perigimol. On page Samach Hey in Otzot Chaim, says like this: Vim Tomim came Lama Alu Ze Ampin VeNigva BeMatzilim BeMatzilam. Why did Ze Ampin and Nukva have to go to the Matzil? Ma'achas Shvaga Yu Shleima BeMashiat Zoch Lahem. If it's something it's Shalom, why does it now have to go back to the Matzil in order to get Shleimus if it's already Shalom? That's his Kasha. Listen to the answer again. Chashuva Hu. התשובה הוא לזה, כי כל חיות הוא אבא ואמא, וכיוון שזכרנו כל אבא ואמא למעלה, אין זה נוקבה ביניהם, רוצה להיפרד. Since אבא ואמא went up, זה אמפים don't feel complete without that attachment. אין זה אמפים, רוצה להיפרד, they don't want to. What do you mean? We're talking lights over here. What do you mean? Rotzen is a will. Rotzen is a mentality, is choice between yes, I want, no, I want. So again, we're seeing humanistic qualities to light. And they wanted to, with all their will and all their desire. We're talking about lights over here. Again, another Marma quiz. And now in Shakud and Perik Dalit. He says as follows: V'da'ki kasha ala ketel matzil. The ketel goes back to the matzil. As otoshi hemshich zman haya ole, as malchu nistalka mimenu bechinat yechida. When the ketel goes back, it loses the level of yechida. The malchut will go up and lose because the ketel is going up, and therefore the shefa that he's giving over to malchut, which is yechida, will stop now because it's going upwards now. So Keter, as Keter is going back into the Pedeak, which is because the Matzil, the creator, the Pedeas Matzil, we have to understand as well. We see that Keter, Fisher Keter, Aya Ole Mistalik, Lo Aya Kamanotol Are. Therefore, his intention, Keter, his intention was not to give Shefa, or this Yechida, to Malchut. Keter has Kavana? Keter has Kavana? Just say the Keter could no longer give Shefa to Malchut because it was going upwards. No. Arisa said, it didn't have Kavana. It's Kavana. That means there's a Rotzen. There was a plan. Keter had a plan here. His Kavana was to go up and not to give Shefa. This is what Kavana. Next. In Sha'akudin Perik Hay now. The Arisa says as follows. Ketzad. I'm not giving you the context, but I'm just giving you the bottom line here. Hine, Keter henir chishimu kedei la'el chokma. V'chen chokma lebina. Bina lezeampin. Vezeampin lukva. Ki le'olam teva ha'elyon la'ali ha'ir lechesh le'tachton. Because the teva, that means the constant natural tendencies of these lights, it's perfectly fine, was to give to the bottom, to give to the tachtonim, to give to the lower levels. V'yesh lo cheshek la'ir kecheshek aval banim. Listen to that. So he said, because the light have a desire, a great desire, like a father to a son. Look at it. It gives in human qualities. Even the Arisa says it's like a father. Like a father. Now, we're dealing with inanimate objects over here. We're talking about just pure light, pure energy that we don't associate any emotional, any human qualities whatsoever. Why is Arisa associating these human qualities, emotional traits that we only find by humans to these lights? He's comparing it to a father and a son. You don't compare a rock to a father and a pebble to a son. That's ridiculous. That doesn't even make sense. To even try to make an anomaly between them, a kesha between them. Let's continue. He doesn't stop at that. I have more proofs from here that the Rizal is learning that energy has free choice, has these human qualities. He says in Shah Nikudin now, Shah Nikudin Perik Beis. He says as follows in Matok Bidvash, if you want to follow, it's in page Kuf Chet. He says, Kavanit Bar Ki Kasher Ratzel Matzil. When the Matzil, Pshutu Kamashma, the translation of Matzil means creator. When the creator, who's the creator, by the way? The Kerem Shlomo, here in Perek Beis Nekudim, Ot Bet, he says the creator is Adam Kadmon. You imagine? The creator that we, Ribono Shalom, we call, the Kerem Shlomo says, is Adam Kadmon. Adam Kadmon, again, Adam comes as a Patsuf. A Patsuf is an inanimate pipes, they call filters, tzinoiros, which connects limala lemata. Adam Kadmon is the Matzil. Matzil decides things. Matzil has powers to create or not create, or create or destroy. All right, look at that. Let's continue. And he says here, Matzil bechinas nikudit kavanoso aita lasos bechinas kelim. It's kavana. Kavana. Kavana, we only find people. Even by a cotton, a human being, Embo Kavana. Embo Kavana. A human being, Kavana. Patsufim, Kavana? What do you make of that? Let's continue. There's many, many more proofs. Let's see in Shah Nikudim Perites. Shah Nikudim says, like this. Lo nishtana tamo kocho ki chazak. Biroto et atzmo bilti keli. Let's start from the beginning. That way we make a little bit of context of it. I don't want to take too much time on them. Sha'os yodu gam hem mekomam. Chutz me'or tiferet shenisha b'mekoma keniska. Lo yorat. Tiferet stayed in its place. V'nimtza ki bli safek. Sha'orot achirim sheyodu mimkomam. Af v'pish'omru sha'ayta yiridatum lezor kel me'ir ba'em. Im kol ze b'yoto lemata mimkoma nechlash kocham lemata. When it all comes down, it weakens itself. לכן אין להם כוח לעלות למעלה, ואור תפארת שעמד במקומו לא נשתן את עמו כוחו כי חזק. But תפארת never dropped down, therefore it never lost its power. בראות את עצמו בלתי כלי, אפשר שיעלה אל המקום שיצא משם, כי לא יחפוץ לאשר אחרו מגולה בלי לבוש. יעזו אלה לבינה, אל המקום אשר עמוד שם בראשונה. Look what he's saying. He's saying, it never lost its strength, but nevertheless, since it saw itself, בראותו את עצמו בלתי, since it saw itself without any kidding, because it only had all, it saw itself, then it thought to itself, maybe let's go up to Bina in order to get a keli. Lo yachpot le'asher ogo migula bluvush. So again, evshel sheyale el amokom asher yatsa misham, lo yachpot, it didn't care, lo yachpot le'asher ogo migula bluvush. But it decided to stay like that without it, without any luvush, any keli. So stay just all without the keli. Look at the words he's using here. It saw itself and then it decided, you know what? I don't care. Lo yachpots? What do you mean I don't care? You have feelings not to care? It didn't mind staying megule, nude, without any levush. That's incredible. All right? Those are just some of the examples we find in Otzot Chaim. Now, let me bring you a Leshem Shebuach Lama. Leshem Shebuach Lama in Sha'a Akudim Perigimo. Otet Zion, he says the following, something absolutely amazing. And again, I'm not going to bring you through the entire context of what he's talking about here. He's talking about the Pasuk of Nishbashem Benafsho. You see that in Shara Kudim, and he says as follows. Zeh so the Pasuk Nishbashem Benafsho. It's a Pasuk in Amos. Ve'ininu, Ininu ki agiloi de Hashem havaya bohu hu beatzilut. The Hashem havaya yud ki vavke came to us as a revealing aspect of the world of atzilut. Ki sham nidgale ma'atzil en sov yibohu leikar Hashem. It's only once the world of atzilut came to be about, then we were able to glimpse into this name of yud ki vavke, which is the predominant power which keeps the world going. And then he said, the kol mashi yotze b'gzeas heskim. I'll read you the whole concept. V'chein sham yesh b'chinet sheva. Ika atzilus hu b'zayin tachtonin. So the ika of the world of atzilus is zayin tachtonin, zayin sviros. That means from chesed all the way down to machlos. Shebehem hu b'chinet sekirim v'aguf la'olamot b'or ensof. Because these spheres of chesed all the way down to malchus are the kelim, the ensof, which comes down to the world of atzilus. ומשם נמשך ויוצא כל ההנהגה והעולמות ביה בכלל ופחת בכל הטוב והפך שבהם. Because everything that comes down to the lower worlds, ביה, will come through the זין תחתון of Atzilus in order to ממשך. כי הזין תחתון היא כפולות בדגש ורפה וכף זכות וכף סחוב. Because this is where it gets a little bit hairy. This is what he's saying. Listen, he's saying that the Zayim Tachtonim hang kfulot bedagish berafa, v'kaf zchut v'kaf chov. It has the power of merit and non-merit. Val yedeim. Now listen to this. Val yedeihem nasis kol anhaga ensof im lechesed im ledin. So once it gets to the power of the Ein Sof instilled inside this kelim of chesed to malchut, it has the power of din and chesed. Bekol ma sheyatzah b'gzeis heskim. Now whatever comes out from heskim, agreement, their agreement, kol ha-zayim zayim tachton kulam. So once the zayim tachtonim all gather together in a meeting and they agree, heskim, hu nikra Shvua. That's called the Shvua. They all take an active part in a meeting, and then they have an agreement, and that agreement is called Shvua, because referring back to the Pasuk, Nishbashem Benafsho. Mishum shekol zayin midos heskimo bize v'gozru al ze. Omnam lo nasa behem shum dava ela me'or en sof ashore betocham. But they can't have the power, they don't actually have the power to create a new mitzvah without the en sof. Imayim kineshama imaguf, kashem itgale en sof baem lifia rotzon veheskem kol zayim kulam. But once they receive this power of the en sof within them, then they create what's called the heskem of all seven. Veyotze gzer mikol zayim midot baftachat. Amazing thing. Imagine there's a heskim, there's a meeting, and they agree or they don't agree. Kav chov, kav zchut. What do you make out of that? We're talking about inanimate light energy as we understand it. Doesn't look like it. Doesn't sound like it from Otzitz Chaim. Doesn't sound like it from the Leshen Shebo Chlama. Now let's look at Sha'a Kavonas. Sha'a Kavonas, when he's talking about the inyan of Sfirat HaOmer. Sfirat HaOmer, we speak about Sha'a Kavonas Dush Dalet HaOmer. And he says, this is what he's saying. Tama lama shvua arishon eno chol gamo. Okay, we're talking about an inyan of Yom HaDekuluhu. We know that the first Shavua of Sfirat HaOmer, the Kavanas is that you have a chesed, an extra chesed that comes down that particular entire week. That particular entire week. And Aval Nikra Chol HaMoed. So, we know that the right after Pesach, the first 2 days in Chutz La'aretz, the first day in the Eretz Yisrael, we have what's called first day is Chag, and then after that you have Chol HaMoed. But he's asking, why is it not called Chol? What's Chol HaMoed? Says Tamu ki kol hachamisha chasadim nechlalim bechesed rishon. Because we have a concept of we have chasadim coming every single day. This is called a special type of chesed which is coming down for that particular week only. We have 7 times 7, 7 weeks for the 49 days of Sfirat HaOmer. The first week is called Yom HaDekulu. We have 7 days of extra chesed. V'zeh sod ma shekotu v'yoma yitzav v'ashem chasdo. Ki ha-chesed rishon nikra yoma. V'shekulam shebo nechla l'mishar ha-chasadim nikra yamim. Gvurot nikra yamim leilot. V'kol echad me'ashem v'bukhinu z'chasadim nikra yom echad. Aval ha-chesed rishon nikra yoma v'lo yom. The first chesed that comes down is called yoma. Not Yom. Or Pirusha. Now, this is where it gets interesting. Yom HaKolel Yamim Rabim. Because this first week includes 49 days. Excuse me. Of Chasadim, which is coming down. Ki kol sha Chasadim ein lahem shoresh umavar ela bo. Because all the other Chasadim of all the other days can only come down through this first Chesed called Yomama. Imagine, this first chesed has the power to allow all the other chesedim come through. That's what he said. Ki al yedei yomam, because through this chesed called yomam, hu ha chesed harishon shebikulam, he's the first chesed. Al yodo hu pakid, because he's called a pakid, he's called the commissioner, the secretary, or I call him the passport control. This first chesed, So this commissioner, this pass control, the first day when we start counting, the first day of the Sfirat HaOmer, the first chesed that comes down, he's the king of chasadim. Now, not only the king, he allows or disallows the other chasadim come down or not. That's what he said. Sha'a Kavonas says, I'll read that again. Shiyehu pakid aleihem. He's like controlling them. Varashut biyodo. And he has the permission in his hand. That means he has the power to what? Lohotziam. To let them allow him to come down. Velohorid. For them, all the other chasadim to come down. All the 49 chasadim to come every single day. Lemata. Kifi rotsono. Kifi rotsono. That means, if he decides that today we're not worthy of chasadim, he's going to deny these chasadim coming down. He can deny? All right, I can go on with examples and examples, but you see from here clearly the way Kabbalah, the way the Arizal, the Leshem, is learning clearly that all these lights are not inanimate objects, if I can call light an object, all right? that even these semi-spiritual things called lights, you know, that we can experience this world, but there's none of our five senses that I can actually hold on to it. It's not a material thing. That's what I mean. So that's what we call like breath or fire. There's also semi-spiritual things that we cannot connect to on a physical basis. It seems to be that it all has some type of brera, some type of free choice. That we keep on saying this Heskim, they have meetings according to the Leshem, they have Rotzam, the Cheshik, all these different words, and to say that it's all love, that is obviously not a way to learn the Arizal. If they want to learn like that, I would tell them to review their learning and maybe start from the beginning again. But anyways, you see clearly that they have some type of free choice, all right? Now, we have more to say about that, but I just wanted to make this very short for everybody. All right, so good Vocht.